Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and we're doing high cheek again today. Why is it so popular? Because it's youth, beauty, and fertility. That lateral high cheek, almost everyone that walks in can get it. It's one of the first things we do. It raises the face. We're gonna do it today. Most commonly now is 25, but even 22 gauge, 2.5 inch microcannulas. Let's watch the procedure being done and how we create beauty with it. So we're gonna do a microcannula high cheek injection to start. The preauricular arteries behind our transverse facial is down a little bit below, and we're gonna make an opening as far back as we can do it because we wanna create a high cheek. We're just above the zygomatic bone here. And I'll grab the cannula. We're using a, grab that one. We're using a 25 gauge, 1.5 inch here. And we wanna keep the areas clean as possible. So a nice way to do that is to place a 4x4 over the hair and enter the opening. And then I see a hollow right through here, which is a nice apex here. And we're filling first the hollow that we see, and next when we fill that to satisfaction, then we'll create a high cheek to create a beauty angle for her. And retrograde injections, filling where we see Restylane, the lift is Nasha technology. Doesn't quite integrate as say refine and define will integrate with the tissue. It more creates a beautiful angle. I want to save a little for the front. I like the apex. We're going to do a two-step approach here. Enter through here to create a little volume in the front. Everyone likes a little more volume in the front because the lid cheek junction, or what some people call the tear trough, improves. And you just have to be patient right here. You'll hit some fibrous tissue, especially if there's filler, Sculptra, or any surgical procedure prior. And as you put product in, you're creating a potential space to go through. Now I want to get just in this area at the lid cheek junction. Sorry, a little more tender there. But we have a microcannula, which does make it more comfortable. And we're going to address the texture with a different type of treatment, but to get the projection and to lift some tissue is what we're using Restylane Lift for. It has an incredible amount of lift that you can produce with the product. It's not as much an integrative product as it is a lifting product. We don't want to overdo the front of the cheek, but we want to have a nice projection. So I'm putting down just small strands as opposed to a larger amount, just to fan the area lateral to the apex. And then that's a two-step approach, one lateral, one forward, that gets you to the lid cheek junction. So thanks for joining me on High Cheek. Stay tuned here, subscribe below. Most importantly, comment. Let us know, what do you like? What don't you like? What method do you like? And with the High Cheek, what's your most favorite product to use? We'll keep you posted. Stay here for beautiful tips to keep your skin and body healthy and vibrant.